Hi there guys, welcome back to another stream. What we'll be playing now is the UFC 3 on the Xbox Series X. As I mentioned earlier, I played the UFC 2 and a UFC 1 before that. So now it's UFC 3's turn, just to see if this game is exactly as I remembered or if it's similar to UFC 4 or more like UFC 2 or UFC 1. In my opinion, this game is more like UFC 4. It sides on that, with the UFC 4 is closer to that than the other two, the first two. So let's see if I'm right or wrong. It's up to test it. It's up to the test. We'll see how it does. But as I remember, this game is more like UFC 4 than the other two. I'm gonna go again for the heavyweight. And choose probably somebody. Maybe Isaac Frost. Actually, let's choose this guy against yeah, let's choose this too. Okay. The same for this game, I haven't played this in a couple of years.
It's a heavyweight showdown between Antonio Rodrigo Minotauro Nogueira and Alexei Oleinik.
As I said earlier, with the UFC 2, I'm really impressed with that game.
Nice pop from
the first one is okay, but it's a bit slow.
The UFC octagon, he brings a lot to the table. Prevailing wisdom though tonight that
the UFC 2 was my favorite so far.
And unleash his
let's
best
see what
weapon,
this brings.
Which is his ground and pound, or till the tape.
So let's see how we do.
Well, it has become the UFC's home away from home of sorts. We are live and underway here at Juness Arena in Rio de Janeiro. Well, here's the mixed martial arts. Oh, big huge right hand.
He's back to his feet.
Yep, it is a. It is similar to UFC 4, more similar to UFC 4 than UFC 2.
Big overhand. There's a nice inside leg kick. Nasty combinations here.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. And he tags him with the straight hand there.
And lands a good shot.
Even visually, it looks very similar to UFC 4.
They've
got a lot in common. I'll be playing that next UFC 4.
Linus lower jaw looking extremely swollen now.
Oh, both men exchange.
He landed that inside leg kick.
Oh, he's hurt! He's hurt!
Ooh.
That one appeared to stun him.
Oh, that one hurt him.
Oh, straight right. Oh, he nailed him. He's down.
Ooh.
Transition to the back. Very nice sweep winds up in his opponent's guard.
Well, then it gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up, Joe. And he's back up again. So the takedowns have been there as have the
defense. Nice punches. Hard overhand punch. Oh, goes down again. Gigantic kicks.
Kick lands for him there. Oh, Leonard gets caught with that punch. His chin is held up thus far. Gotta shore up the defense here, though. Oh, back up again. You can't hold a good man down.
What the hell is he doing? Stop getting up. I think it's a glitch. I think it's a glitch. He's just staying there. It was hilarious. It's a good game, it's not bad. The graphics too, they look great on the Series X. Even though it's a port from previous Xboxes, it still looks great. Done.
Dropped them and then took care of business on the ground. Really excellent, excellent job.
Yeah, Joe, that was some throwback style ground and pound. He was trying to pound his opponent's head through the damn canvas. He wasn't looking to score there. He was looking to land big shots and get his opponent out of there. Well, mission.
That was a proper octagon. Bruce Buff. Okay, the one. Let's choose someone else, not heavyweight. Let's choose somebody else in a light heavyweight, maybe. Richard Evans versus Griffith. Actually, I choose Rampage Jackson against this guy. Yeah, let's go against this guy. Let's change it to normal. That was a bit easier than the previous one. Let's change it to normal. See how we do on normal. If I get my ass kicked, all right, coming that's up. Fine.
And now our tip.
You ready? You ready?
And we are underway. Opens with the left hand and lands flush. Strike
count. Great combinations. I like the way he's mixing these up. Oh! Oh, nice right hand. He hurt him. Oh, he's getting hit.
The big right hand.
High kick. He hurt
him. Ooh, that was.
He missed with that jab attempt there.
Big kick to the head. He is stunned.
He's got him hurt here. Oh, he might be out. Oh, straight right. All right, so a swing and a miss there. And
oh, he's tagging him. Oh, he hurt him again.
Ooh.
He's got to be careful there. Don't rush in. Powerful jab.
Combinations here.
Body kick, look at that.
Oh, big left hook over the top.
Oh, he missed that kick.
Uzdemir gets caught by the inside leg kick. A few more, and that'll leave a mark. Oh, massive kick. Didn't see that one coming.
Nice head kick. Look at that nasty jab.
Back and forth we go. Well, he left his head open there, Joe, and he got cracked with that jab. He was almost moving into it. So let's see if he can switch up the footwork here, Joe, and make the requisite adjustments. Ozdemir's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling.
Oh, another one.
He's got him hurt here.
Oh, he's hurt. He's hurt.
He's done. Yeah, he's done.
Huge right hand victory.
Yeah, Joe, a pinpoint strike to end this fight. It landed flush. I'm not even sure the opponent wholly saw it coming. And before he could recover, the referee was in to stop the fight. So a huge knockout victory for that fighter here tonight.
Here we see it from another camera angle.
Yep.
All right, we send it inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Okay, let's do another one. Just a test. With the middleweights or the lightweights. Or even the ladies. I'll try the ladies. Lightweight. Actually, let's try these two. Yeah, let's try these two. Looks like Khabib and Connor. Let's change the venue. Let's change our two arena. No, it's not bad. The movement is a bit, you know, when you're trying to strike. There's a bit of a... It looks like a delay or something like that when you try to do a move. It's not like quick, it's got like a delay that number two didn't have. I'm not a big fan of that.
Scheduled for five-minute rounds here tonight. Oh, useful, well-placed kick there. Oh, nicely done with the head kick.
Caught him with a punch.
Nurmagomedov gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds. Strong work with the inside leg kick.
They're going after it quick here.
Conor McGregor gets touched by that kick to the body. Oh, another damaging head kick lands Joe, and defensively, the opponent's got to start thinking about blocking some of these. I know he prides himself on his toughness and his chin, but the next one could knock him down and potentially out of this fight.
Exactly.
Effective jab there by Nurmagomedov. Landed that one. Again, going back to the jab, just out of range. Oh, he got cracked with the jab there, Joe, and his head is firmly on the center line, the one place it really can't afford to be. He's showing some vulnerability here by leaning right into his opponent's range. Let's see if he can make some adjustments here. Nurmagomedov gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Oh, nice jab by McGregor.
Whoa!
And both guys really throwing with authority.
He's doing a great job of mixing things up here, keeping it unpredictable. Good kick. Nice.
McGregor's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Strong straight left there. Able to land to the body there with the left kick. Well, he just hasn't been efficient with his strikes here tonight. There's another swing and a miss. And at this point, if he can't preserve some stamina moving forward, this is going to end up being an awfully long night.
Whoa! He is stumbling.
Now a right hand.
Oh! Oh, he's knocked down. That's it. That's it.
Unbelievable.
Big roundhouse kick KO for the victory.
Oh, that was a no-doubter, Joe. That might
have been God.
The likes of Edson Barboza. A tremendous
and my stamina.
To spell the end of the night for his opponent tonight. He couldn't have caught him much more flush than that, Joe.
Full my force, fault.
Beautifully extends the leg right to the target, and that is the end of the
yeah,
fight.
Yeah, lost my guard there, yeah, definitely, yep.
Could be $50,000 richer after that highlight turned in here tonight.
Let's take a look at that again. Check it out again. Oh, man. K-O.
I was going to knock him down, but I lost my guard there. Just didn't pay attention.
Huge knockout under the lights.
As you can see from his face.
The official decision is in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine.
Okay, so let's try the ladies now. Mm. I don't mind the loss. Who should we choose? Paige VanZant? She looks hot. Alexander Albu. Chambers. Let's go for Kaylin. Let's go for these two hotties. Okay.
All right, coming up next, yes, a women's strawweight matchup between Kylan Curran and Paige VanZant. Our tale of the tape for...
Let's see how we do with the ladies.
All right, so we get another look tonight at the young strawweight contender, Paige VanZant. She's a well-rounded fighter, does everything pretty well, plus finishing skills, both in terms of her knockouts and her submissions. Freestyle fighter representing Team Alpha Male in Sacramento, California.
Welcome to the jungle.
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active.
Beautiful jab. Jabs off the left and jabs off the right.
Curran gets caught with that punch.
Oh!
Ooh.
Tries a big hook to the head, but misses.
Well, she left her body wide open, Joe, and as such, she paid for it there. Beautifully placed and landed kick to the body. Let's see if she makes the adjustments here defensively to avoid absorbing any more.
I didn't see Ronda in the roster, so
right hand over the top.
I'm not sure if she was on the game. Or maybe it's a DLC or something, but I didn't see her there. I was gonna choose her. But she wasn't there.
Back to the jab. She lands the head kick. 2 minutes have expired off the round one clock here. Head kick. We gotta fight, folks.
Oh, ooh, that was...
Oh, very nice.
Another kick to the body by Curran. VanZant gets caught by the inside leg. Well, she is clearly cast out at this point of the fight.
He's a tough man.
Is low, and even when she misses a strike,
that's tough, yeah.
Effort as well, so not a good look for her here. VanZant gets absolutely punished by that head kick. Lands a strike there. Under 2 minutes to go. Oh, she's got a cut above the eye here. We'll keep an eye on it.
Watch out for the stamina.
Just missed with a huge kick.
I haven't got much stamina, so I gotta be careful if I don't want to finish like McGregor.
Wow, big overhand right miss.
She landed a head kick there. Curran getting tattooed by that stiff jab.
Oh, that was a nice hit.
Wow. Wow! Big shots!
How did she survive that? I got an idea.
Oh! Ooh. Like that, the fight is over.
I'm done.
Punch on the button, got the win.
Yeah, Joe, I'm not sure she could have drawn it up.
Impressive, impressive.
Strike to end the fight for her opponent, who candidly may not have even seen that flush shot coming.
Look at that, man.
This is exactly the way she drew
proper.
It up. She told us during fight week that she had to find a way to finish this fight to
I think that was
on
the Joe.
The rest of this division. Message
yep.
Sent.
Damn it.
Here it is one more time.
Just a look at that. Whew.
Good night.
And there she is after the huge knockout here tonight. What a moment.
Well done, well done.
You can't help but feel good for her here tonight.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision. Referee Herb Dean called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 34 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, 12-gauge Paige VanZant.
All right, so Paige VanZant is your winner, and there it is, that million-dollar smile. We've essentially watched her grow up and evolve inside this octagon. And
well done, Paige. Well done.
She took her game and her skills to that requisite next level. Interesting opportunity now for the matchmakers as they set up her next fight here at a...
Very interesting fight, yeah. They're both really good, actually. So, guys, thanks for watching this stream. Hope we'll see you on the next one. Next, we'll be playing UFC 4. Just to compare to UFC 3. So I'll be just a couple of minutes. I'm going to end the stream and start another stream. Okay, so see you in a second. Take care. Bye-bye.